So it is Sunday about 1 o'clock, and just now leaving the house. We got a whole bunch of camera equipment put together to start a new part of this channel. What I'm hoping to do is I was gonna call it What's Going On Russellville, and I was gonna go to a bunch of small businesses, Russellville events, and you know, activities and whatnot, and then also places like, you know, the lake, the mountain, and all that, state parks, city parks, just whatever we thought was cool for Russellville, and shoot this video series showing off the town that we love so much. And we love living here and all the small little businesses that people maybe have not heard of, or they're not on the main streets, you know, something where somebody could sit and talk to us and explain to us all of it, you know, what they do and why they do it. But I think we're gonna go shoot a little video real quick and, you know, do kind of today's vlog along with all this. But we're looking for ideas and we're looking for businesses around here that's willing to participate in it, especially if I can get a chauffeur to walk us around and be like, hey, here's, you know, here's the company, here's what we do, here's what we sell, you know, here's the food we make. We kind of do cool little stuff like that. We just got to find the places. But we're going to go over to the little train depot right now and show you guys the little train depot here. Went to Stobie's yesterday with a B, right? Stobie's.
Yeah.
We should have got the sandwiches. That's what they're known for. We need to go back in one of these days and eat lunch there and actually have a sandwich. Because the hamburger I had was just okay at best, and the salad she had was okay at best.
We also.
But we can, we're going to go back there and actually have, you know, what they're really known for. Plus the pies. Pies look very good. 18 bucks or so for it. Shaved my head today too, by the way. So I'm all itchy. I got little bits of hair on me. So we're kind of just taking a Sunday and hanging out and cruising around and seeing what we do and seeing what we get. I'm gonna sit down and explain this channel to everybody too, why we made it and all that, you know, why we named it the whole thing. So that's coming up here shortly. We're pulling into Russellville right now. We're into downtown Russellville right now.
They're open?
Huh. I thought the bar was closed. And they're actually open. So,
Burger time.
We'll see how the day goes. Yeah.
Yep.
So we are in what they call the Russellville Depot District. Hey, you know one downside to having the GoPro stuck to your head? It's the mark from the mount. So we're riding on scooters and I have the GoPro strapped in my head. But you look here on the signs. It's a depot district because this has been the train station for what? Since the mid 1800s? This was the main train station in town, and then when the train station closed, this became like rec hall, maybe?
There's a museum in there.
Museum, rec hall. I know you can rent it out. They had a themed party here not too long ago, but this is a little amphitheater. So they, what do they call this? The
circle?
This part. Oh. I thought they called it like the circle or something like that. And this is a amphitheater. So you can sit on the grass. And they have the stage with lights and lots of plugins. It's wired for sound. You know, you could have concerts or plays here. can have a whole bunch of stuff.
It's really cool.
Yeah, they have like a little backstage area.
This little back room. You know, there's wireless boxes and lights, projector.
That white part's a screen so they can play movies on it. They have farmer's market every week here, right?
Yeah.
Yep. It's probably out of season now, but the have a farmer's market. They have Indian thing here not that long ago. The chili cook-off is going to be here, but mostly more towards downtown. Downtown's just a block away. And then, you know, they kind of try and do a whole bunch of stuff here. But it's laid out very well, and it's kind of a cool little place. For a town of, what, 20,000? 29,000. This little area does quite well.
Yeah.
It's cool. It's pretty cool.
We come over here to do the circle on our scooters all the time.
What?
And practice leaning.
But here, since it's set up for farmers market, what they have wired in here are these little boxes.
So the setup for power, 50 amp plug-ins.
So you could technically plug an RV into it, but when they have taco trucks and vendors and big things, they have
these boxes set up
for power. It's pretty cool. Would you want to live up downtown like this?
Yeah.
I don't know if I would.
For like a month.
But it's a cool place. Well, we're over here at one of our favorite places in Russellville. I guess it's safe to say this is one of our favorite places. Old Post Park.
Yeah.
So
this is the start to the disc golf course.
And the disc golf course goes over most of the park. So
it's directly across from the tennis courts. There is a parking lot right here, and hole number one is right here. And you can keep score on your phone. And they have, every single one of them's got the course layout, the two different holes. It's hard to tell, but it's behind this tree over there. There's a practice putting tee there.
But the course goes
through here, over the hill, all the way through the woods. There's a cool
water hole too, where the green is almost completely surrounded by water. I believe that was hole 13 over there. And I personally think it's the best disc golf course in Russellville by quite a large margin.
And right now with the leaves falling off here, it is
absolutely beautiful. But here in this park as well, there's
also tennis courts and basketball courts. And they're very popular. They are lit at night. You can play
all the way up until I believe about 10 o'clock. And then the dam for the lake is right here, and we're gonna head over there next. But
I love this place.
And this park in general, but mainly this disc golf course is about the best one in the Russellville area. I know there's another one in Arkansas that used to be a golf course, and now it's a disc golf course. I forgot where it was at exactly. That's one of the best disc golfing courses in the state. But this is very, very nice for this area, at least.
But it's beautiful here today.
About 72 degrees too, so it's about perfect. So here is the dam itself. That's a little miniature houseboat.
Uh-huh.
we can catch this guy coming in.
It's a little mini houseboat pulling into the lock. So this is the lock and dam for Lake Dartnell. How'd you like to live on that?
What do you think that's going to cost him?
It's free.
Oh.
Yeah, remember the guy was saying it's free to go through it?
And this is usually where I go fishing at. So you have the stairs right here going down from the parking lot here.
Man, that's going to be rough going up in that little thing.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it's going to be bad. It's going to be real turbulent. They said when they turn the pumps on it, it really gets a rocking in there.
But this is just the end of the road on Old Post Park. And then the lock and dam.
The power plant's making power right now. You can see water coming out of the bottom of it. They only make power a couple hours a day, right?
Yeah.
Like 3 to 9 hours a day or something like that. And the lake's level's got to be a certain lake level and all that.
But yeah, we caught that little itty-bitty boat going in there.
It was pretty cool. You don't see that very often here. But
this is the dam, and this is one of the best catfishing places
in Russellville area.
Yeah.
And on the Arkansas River. Right below any dam's pretty good. There's some guys way out there floating. You probably can't even see them with this GoPro, but they're out there fishing right now, and I wish we could be out there on a boat fishing. Because we need a boat payment. That's what I need in my life, is a boat payment.
Yeah.
So, yeah, this is one of our favorite places to come to. One of our favorite parks to come to. So, Lynn's is one of my favorite places to eat. Ate a lot of pho. Their pho is pretty good.
Yeah.
What are you gonna get?
I don't know. It kind of smells weird here.
She's so picky. She just needs to eat pho, but she refuses to. She doesn't like soup. And I love it. I've eaten pho all over the country, and this is one of the better places that I've ever had.
Ashley's probably just gonna get stir fry.
She's so picky and just such a Debbie Downer.
Next always, time we're gonna go get.
Always have something negative to say.
But yes, I love pho. Absolutely love it. Love coming here. So if you come to Russellville, you should come to Lynn's and try the pho.
You have the comfy chicken.
What?
Our Kung Pao chicken. It's really good.
Did you get it?
No, it's too spicy.
Oh, I forgot.
Keep forgetting Kung Pao chicken is spicy. It's good though. So this is pho. I can't have any vegetables and sprouts and all that stuff. I'm allergic to it. So I just have to have meat, noodles, and broth. But you put the hoisin sauce in it, and a little bit of sriracha.
And it's a very nice soup, warm.
So Vietnamese kind of comfort food too.
What'd you get?
Stir fry. With egg noodles.
She loved it. Came out very well.
It's delicious.
But man, I love pho.
Man, I love Lynn's.
Yep, it was yummy.
I'll eat pho every day of the week if I had a choice. She doesn't like it at all. I like Mexican soup too as well. But I wish we had a ramen place here. Do you even like ramen? That was a good lunch. Very good lunch. $29 too, by the way.
Hanging out with the puppies. Arr. Get it. Get it, Brody. Get it. Get it. Come on, Brody. Get it.
Thank you.
Get a birdie. Would you stop, Dad? Hey, Molly. Hi, guys. Hey, Pepe. Hey, buddy.
I've been doing this to him since he's a little puppy. He loves just doing it. Hanging out underneath my shirt. Come on out. I need to trim his face so bad. Well, just got home from a scooter ride. We're not gonna do the nasty taste test. And we're probably gonna do a little computer work and go to bed. So Ashley's gonna take the dogs out here.
Molly,
we're gonna go to bed. See you guys tomorrow.